My name is Ricardo Dew. I live at 5113 Brewer Court. I'm here again because we're back into the can of worms that y'all opened up when you had Electric City here. But what has not been known to the public is, since Duke Power has bought out Progress Energy, how that is going to affect these 32 cities that's in the power agency, how that's going to affect Wilson. Nothing has been said. It's never been in the paper. Y'all are not addressing it. Nobody's saying anything about it. But we know there is going to be a rate increase from that. It may not be this year, but it's coming. So, with the $1 million that y'all are deciding to use to fight a battle that's not a winning battle for y'all because of the fact that it's Rocky Mount, you can't control Nash County. You can't control what Sanderson Farms do in Nash County. If they want to build and Nash County say build, they're going to build. You have to rely on the state and federal government to do their job, not spend my taxpayers' money for something that the state and federal government can do. So with that and with the insight of knowing that there is going to be a rate increase, let's be a little more proactive than we have been in the past years with this electric thing. Let's put some money up, let's put some money aside to help these people when this rate increase actually happens. Those who cannot afford to pay it now is not going to be able to afford to pay it then. You talk about saving, you talk about weatherizing your houses, you talk about everything. But when you look at these houses in East Wilson, no amount of weatherization is going to help them with their electric bill. Once they start doing it, if it's up to the city to actually regulate what these landlords are doing to these houses. People have been living in these houses for 40 years, and the value of these houses is $20,000, $30,000, if that much, and they've been paying rent for 40 years. How many times have they paid for that house? So if you force them to do something to that house to make it livable, then they're going to raise the rent. So I think that what the city needs to do, instead of worrying about something else going on in another county, worry about your own home first. Look out for the people who vote for you. Look out for the people who's paying taxes. Look out for the people who's paying salaries. Look out for the people who are struggling, trying to get a job. Look out for those people here in Wilson. You go all over the state, you get all this recognition. You got a recognition about the comprehensive plan, but I can just about guarantee you those people who are giving y'all recognition for that plan have not been to Wilson to see just what that plan will or will not do for a certain section of this city. So we need to do the whole city, not just part of the city. Look at what's hurting the most first and take care of that. Let's prioritize what we do in this city and what we do for the people of this city first. And let's make that a priority. Let's look ahead. Let's be more proactive than we have been in these past years and try to help those who are not going to be able to survive when rate increases go on, when jobs continue to fail. Let's look out for those people. Let's think about that. Take that $1 million. Are you going to be able to find $1 million next year? If you can find one now to fight a losing battle, I should sure hope that you can find one next year to help people who is going to need it. Thank you.
Anyone else?